Instructional design portfolios that show off AI skills are going to outperform anything else on the market in the months and years to come. And that's why today I want to share with you the portfolio of Davis Rideout, someone who took the initiative to dive deep with a new AI tool, and the market is definitely noticing. So I met Davis through my instructional design bootcamp, and then when we got the bootcamp licensed and turned it into PEC Academy, Davis was one of the first people to transition over and do the certification program. That being said, I think we were all a bit surprised at just how quickly Davis started landing interviews before he even completed the program, and I have a feeling his portfolio has something to do with that, so let's dive in here. So here's Davis's website. It's a bit different. We have this nice full width, full screen experience the whole way through. I'm going to, of course, share some feedback as we go, just, suggest ways that Davis could push things even further. So it's very personalized. Right when we land here, we get a feel for who Davis is. Davis is leveraging some AI headshot generators to get some nice professional headshots that he can use across different platforms. I think my feedback so far would be some small things. I would probably try a different font right here just to add more contrast with this header font, or you could even try a different display font here for his header just to add a bit more personality here and add more contrast. And then with this featured project button, it definitely pops. It draws my attention to it. I really want to click on it, but I would maybe try reducing the kerning. So that's the space between the letters. We don't really use that a wide kerning anywhere else except for on these buttons. So I would play around with that. And then we could also experiment with making the links in the nav bar here consistent with the font size of this button and make this button the same font size as well and add that same font weight, so bolding it. So just some small consistency things, but nice and personalized. I like the full screen thing. It really pulls me in. He has a customized logo here. I think the name in the logo might be small on smaller screens, so you could even try removing your name from that logo and putting it to the right of the logo and making it a bit bigger, and then just having that D or that D in a circle being the logo. So these are some small things. Instead of clicking on featured project here, I'm going to keep scrolling down. We will definitely look at that project soon though. So then we get down here is the featured project. It's about gentle parenting, an immersive e-learning experience to reduce stress and increase connection with your kids. So leading with the value of what this experience will help us with. I like that, right? Very plain language about what it's going to help us accomplish here. My feedback in this section is again around the small spacing stuff. I would probably try to bring this button into this box here, align it with the left of this S to have a nice cohesive box. But I know just from talking to Davis that Squarespace doesn't always cooperate with the spacing that you want. So Davis got this online, and again, it's already helping Davis land a lot of interviews and get noticed in the industry. There are some ways we could, if we want to be meticulous, we could push, these little details even further. But I think his project speaks for itself, and we'll take a look at that soon. So I'm scrolling down. I like how things animate in. I like we have this contrast between these two fonts here. Beautiful design. It's italicized. It's a bit more fancy. And then powerful science. It really pops. It's nice and bold. I would probably bring these closer together. So again, just a spacing thing. Bring this closer to powerful science just to have more of that proximity here. More AI visuals. So as you're going to see throughout this website, Davis is really good at generating AI visuals, and he shows that off. So yeah, nice way to show people engaging and interacting with the e-learning experiences that he is creating. We have this call to action to contact Davis in case we're interested about a project. So that's good to have there. We have these testimonials. I would probably suggest bolding certain parts of the testimonials. And this is something we've started doing too. But let's see, like maybe this sentence right here. Like, Davis has demonstrated an outstanding ability to blend instructional design principles with high-level creativity, ensuring that learners not only absorb the content, but also feel inspired to apply it in their own lives. So that's a powerful statement. I would probably bold that just so it pops. Maybe you could split this up into multiple paragraphs, maybe same over here, just to make it a bit more scannable and easy for people to get the juiciest parts out of these testimonials. And then if we scroll down further, I know this is something Davis recently added. We could probably adjust the background to be a bit more consistent and dark like we have on these other screens. A nice you know, simple contact form if we want to reach out here. So very solid home screen, I'd say. It has all the necessary elements. We've got the social proof. It ends with the contact form so we could reach out. We have the featured project. And of course, we can learn more about Davis. So let's dive into this featured project. So this is the page we land on when we click on that button. I think I would like a bit more hierarchy here. So maybe like a heading here that kind of says gentle parenting and maybe has this subtitle as well in the hero section so that I can orient myself as soon as I land on this page. Because the quote is cool. It's good. Speak with your children as if they are the wisest, kindest, most beautiful humans on earth, for what they believe is what they will become. I think that's a really powerful quote for guiding this project. And I think it is attention grabbing, but I also want to make sure, you know, I want to know that I landed on the right page. So we want to use those web elements and highlight that this is that gentle parenting page, have that subtitle to tell us what it is, then maybe have the quote and then this experience the project button. So these are small details, just some user experience things. And again, he nails it right when we scroll down a little bit. Well, let's open up this project. So I'll start it here. So you probably won't be able to hear it on your end. Maybe you will actually, but he has sound effects on every single one of these slides, and it's really nice. So very well balanced title screen here. We're introduced to our children. We sense that there are things we could do better, but we aren't sure where to start. And notice the balance here. So I know, you know, Squarespace can be frustrating with how we want to space things and whatnot. But when Davis is on a canvas like storyline and he can really align things how he wants, it's really nice, all the padding and margin and white space he's using. And yeah, these are all AI visuals. So again, I'm going to show a clip from Davis. If you want to learn how he did this, he actually recorded something for us to kind of give us a behind the scenes look. But yeah, he really solid character consistency. Notice it where like the framing changes, the setting changes, but it has this nice warm glow that's really drawing us into the experience. So I'll let you experience that for yourself at davisrideout.com. So check it out. It's a pretty cool project. And like I said, I'm gonna turn it over to Davis soon for that process video that he shared with us in the bootcamp space. But I would love to see a video like that on this page. So we're actually even gonna update like our content in the academy and the bootcamp, and we're gonna have people create video process overviews essentially, where they can show off the most engaging parts of their project and give us a behind the scenes look at how they built some of it. So I think that's such a powerful way to build connections with hiring managers, potential clients, other people in the field. So yeah, maybe even right beneath this hero section, we could feature that video that I'm going to show you, or I'm going to show you a clip of, or maybe even Davis could record something deeper where he does show that off and build that connection at scale. Because again, that's a really powerful thing that you can do with your portfolio site. So we do have the full process write up. Again, little spacing things, like you notice that this heading is a little closer to this paragraph than the one that it's referring to. So if you're starting to learn about visual design, this is that proximity piece. So, you know, you want the heading to be more proximate to the text associated with it. I know, you know, there's been some frustrating Squarespace template issues, but yeah, just something we could do to push this even further when we're not too busy interviewing right now like Davis is. But just something to point out. We have these screenshots. We can see the whole process in the works. Again, this is like, we always say this is 50% of your portfolio project is showing off your process so that people can see how you did what you did. And again, now we're going to take it even a step further with these video process write-ups so you can get practice talking through your process to an audience, which is really helps in interviews. So there we have that. I think this would be a good time to hand it over to Davis. You can get a little behind the scenes clip at how he got such consistent characters and brought this project to life. And then I'll continue the portfolio review after we get back from that.
Hello, my name is Davis. I wanted to give you a little bit of kind of share some knowledge and information that I've gathered from how to create character consistency in a project. So I'm still working on building this project out, but I've had some successes in creating some consistent characters, AI, through the story. So we're going to see Sarah, Robert, and then our third character here is Krista. And if we zoom in on Krista, this is a great example of some of the character consistency that I was able to get using open art AI. You can see that it looks like very much the same character, same facial features. Looks like it looks like she's in the same environment. So great success with you know all of the little details too, like her fingers. Everything looks very believable. So if we zoom out here, we can go and we can kind of see, yep, Sarah's here, all looking like the same girl, the same character in these different scenes, different scenarios. She's clearly in a grocery store. Here we have her in the car. Robert gets introduced at this point. He's playing his iPad, has a difficult time going to soccer practice with some of the different scenarios that we have here. But you can see that there's a great deal of character consistency going through each one of these scenarios. And then even combining the characters into a single scene. We've got Sarah and Robert both. Now, Sarah's hair has gotten a little longer here. So maybe a bit more time has gone by. But little details like that shouldn't get picked up much. But it very much looks like the same characters as they're going through the story. We can see here some of their great facial expressions between Robert and Sarah. It's not perfect, but it is much better than a lot of the other AI character generation software that I've seen. So the way that this works with OpenART is that you're actually able to create multiple characters. And when you create a character, you give it some reference points. You kind of say, like, this is what I want the character to look like. And then it spends a good amount of time kind of developing that character and really understanding what that character is. Once you have your character generated, then you're able to go through and give it a prompt that says, you know, something like Sarah 2. So this is the second Sarah, and then is playing guitar, is, you know, upset in a grocery store, is, you know, sitting in a car booster, whatever your prompt is. Now, AI prompting, if you're at all familiar with it, you will have to get decent at it and understand how your platform is working. As you can see, I've had a lot of different options here, trying to get just them in a school portrait, you know, like photo, and then, you know, AI will send you things like this. You know, Sarah with her prayer hands in front of the photo.
Okay, so there was a bit about how Davis created this project. Again, I'm going to encourage Davis to share a longer video like this where he goes behind the scenes on his website. So make sure you check it out if you're curious. I'm going to dive back into his site though now, and we're going to look at his about page. So again, really good example of how Davis is using this website to build relationships at scale, giving us some professional insight, some educational insight, and then some personal insight. So we found that this can do really well on your portfolio site, sharing some more personal information, right? Bringing people into what your life is like, giving people opportunities to connect with you, right? Other people who have families or kids or really involved parents can really connect to some of the stuff that Davis is saying on here. So check it out. Really nice personal relationship building about page. We, of course, have a contact page. I think the Let's Talk button brings us here as well. We might not need this contact link here if we have Let's Talk. So we could probably remove one of these. And then again, just small spacing feedback. We could probably bring this text up closer to the heading, maybe make this text smaller and bring it closer to the icons it's associated with. I know Davis might get frustrated even watching this because the site can look different on the different breakpoints. A tool like Squarespace doesn't give you as much control over something like Webflow. So when you go to the site, this might look perfect, but on other breakpoints or other monitor sizes, things might shift a little bit. So to everyone who has been frustrated with their website builder, I'm sure that Davis can relate to your experiences. So this is Davis's website. Check it out for yourself. He also has some other projects you can dive into here. So for example, check out the survival challenge. Check out these AI visuals. Very cool, right? Being able to have a full screen visuals like this that span the width of it. I mean, you can imagine how much this would immerse someone into an e-learning experience. I think he did similar. I'm not even sure if these are AI generated, these photography ones. Like they could be, but I mean, you know, it's showing off actual products. So So yeah, he's really pushed it further with that tool that you heard him talk about. He's done a great job with it. And yeah, he's not even finished the program and he's already going through multiple rounds of interviews. So I have a feeling he's going to be in a role he's happy with within a few weeks of me recording this video. So thanks for making it to the end of this video. I will say that if you are transitioning into instructional design and you want to work with me and my team as you build your skills and create your portfolio website and get your name out there in the job market, we would love to work with you. Today, the day this video goes live, marks the last day to apply to the first cohort of PEC Academy. So this is our licensed career school. It's our certification program. We're doing a lot of cool stuff with this. So if you want to try to squeeze in and still secure your seat for the first cohort, we will give you some space to apply. You can go to pecacademy.com. I'll also include that link in the description and you'd be in great company. We have a lot of really motivated students just like Davis who are doing really cool things in the industry already. And we'd love to see you in there. And no matter what you do, more free content will be coming your way and I will see you in the next video.